Hello YouTube, I wanted to do another experiment with the pulsed system on the toroid. I apologize because I have so many videos about these pulsed systems, but this one is going to be different. So we're going to be pulsing 4.5 inch ring or 5 inch ring, and we have two bifilar coil over here, and we have clockwise wound coil here and a clockwise wound coil here. And as you can see here, this is a basic schematic right here, and we're going to be doing different things to these two coils. One time we're going to be shorting it out and measuring the voltage on the other coil, then we're going to be just measuring the voltage when it's open, both of the coils are open, and in the other case we're going to have all the coils connected in series, so theoretically voltage should be highest over here. And then we're going to connect this spiral wound capacitor. So I made a spiral wound capacitor yesterday. We're going to be connecting the spiral wound capacitor to one of the coils, and I made it using aluminum tape, 3-inch aluminum tape, and I just had two aluminum tapes wound together around a 5-inch PVC coupler. So okay, let's get started. So we're gonna start with this, with the two coils being open, and I have my voltmeter over here and it's set to AC. So okay, let's turn it on. I already adjusted the potentiometer, so I'm not gonna mess with the potentiometer throughout the whole experiment, so we have to leave that the same. Okay, so let's see, 9.51 volts from a single coil. Okay, okay, now let's next thing, we're gonna short out the secondary coil. Okay, so we have shorted out this this coil over here. So this coil is shorted out and the voltmeter is connected to this coil. Okay, so here we go. See the tone changed. And now we're getting 1.35 volts with this coil being shorted. Okay. Next is, so let's record that voltage over here. So next thing, we're gonna connect my spiral capacitor to this coil. Okay, so I connected the spiral wound capacitor to this coil over here. And again, if you use the aluminum tape, it's really ideal for these spiral capacitors, I believe, because it already comes with a backing, a paper backing. So if you use aluminum foil and some parchment, it's really hard to keep all the layers lined up. And I've had some issues trying to build a capacitor that way. Ievan äiti se tyttö se vahti, vaan kyllähän Ieva se juttu. Sillä eipäkä silloin kiellot haittaa, kun löö tanssimme laijasta laitaa. Sani yli puttuttaa, tappu täppi tikkut hiljalleen. Ievan suu oli vehnää sellä, koimme se tonne toivotti. Pää oli märkänä jokaisella ja viulu se vonkuu ja voivotti. Ei tänä paikoo märkyy saattaa, sillä se laskoo laijasta laitaa. Sani yli puttuttaa, tappu täppi tikkut hiljalleen. Ievan äiti se kammaarissa virsiä veisata huijutti. So okay, let's see. So now spiral wound capacitor is attached to this coil, and we're getting voltage from this coil. Okay, let's see. Nine point 96 volts. Okay. 9/8. Okay. So next is we're going to connect the two coils together in series and then get voltage from that. Okay, so now this coil and this coil are connected in series, and their wind is in the same direction, remember, so we should get double the voltage now. So let's run the experiment. Okay, we're getting 18.45 volts, let's say, 18.45 volts. So we are getting double the voltage this way. Okay. Okay, now we connected the coils in parallel. So this coil and this coil are connected here, and this coil and this coil is connected at the top. And we're getting the voltage across. Sort of in as in a Leeds-Kalman design, but his coils were wound in the opposite. One of the coils was wound in the opposite direction. So here we're getting two coils fighting each other. So you have the same fields at the end of the coil and over here. Sort of how I drew this schematic here. See, you have two same poles on the same side. So theoretically, we should be getting a very little voltage at this point. Let's see. As you can see, we're getting very little voltage, 0.04 volts. Okay. Okay. So I ran the experiment with one more change. Is so I have the two coils shorted out with themselves, and then I put the spiral wound capacitor right here, and so now we're getting voltage. We're getting 10.33 volts, and the most curious thing is that the voltage actually keeps rising ever so slowly. See, it just rose by a tenth of a volt, but it may not seem significant, but it was rising by a tenth of a volt for the past minute. So see, it rose by a tenth of a volt again. So I can't really explain why it's doing that. And so I just let it run. No, there it goes. It rose by a tenth of a volt. So we're gonna see how far it will actually rise. And it's not clear why it's doing that. I'm really baffled why the voltage keeps rising. So the only thing that I did was I added an extra that spiral capacitor right here, so everything shorted out, and our voltmeter is across here and here, these two points. See, it rose again by a tenth of a volt. So I'm just gonna let it run, and then I after an hour, I guess I'm going to do an update, see if the voltage actually reaches a value and levels off. But to me, this is most curious why the voltage keeps rising. So let this setup run for about 20 minutes, and it's still fluctuating, but it's not moving quite as fast as it was. Now it's 11.76 volts. So and it's going up a little bit. Anyway, well, I'm gonna keep experimenting, you guys. If I find anything interesting, I'll post the video. It's just increased again. Anyway, these spiral capacitors are supposed to be used in sets. So this one is counterclockwise. I need to make a clockwise one, because these are the kind of capacitors that Lester Hendershot was using. Well, just about. And so this one has 8 turns of 3-inch aluminum tape. Anyway, you guys.